Hi YouTube family, it's your friend Ashwani and welcome to Let's Share Solutions. Today I am here at the Taj Mahal. Yes, I was born and brought up in Delhi, but surprisingly, in 34 years of my existence, I've never been to Taj Mahal. And today also I've come here for a public speaking conference. But I've come to Agra and I don't visit Taj Mahal, that was not good. So I'm here. But I also have a guest with me today, a very good friend of mine. His name is Pavan Madamsetty. Hello, Pavan.
Hi, Ashwani. Very good morning.
Pavan, can you please tell about your professional profile to our viewers?
Yeah, absolutely, Ashwani. So I work as a management consultant and I help companies grow their business. So I work with a lot of MNCs to help them enter new markets in Asia Pacific. I also help a lot of Indian companies to enter new markets in Asia. So that is majorly the role I have.
Great. So because he has such a vast experience of working with MNCs, he's always, he has visited most of the countries in the world. He's met a lot of big companies all over the world. So I thought that his coming on this channel will help a lot to my subscribers. That is the reason I've created this video, so that he can share his expertise and help our subscribers. So Pavan, there are a lot of things that I can learn from you. Maybe in future I will have more interviews with Pavan, but in this video I would like to just focus on one thing. Let's talk about goal setting, because this applies to all the subscribers that I have,
right?
Be it students, be it entrepreneurs or job seekers, we all have goals in our life. We want to achieve goals, just like my goal of getting rid of the tummy and becoming fit. You can see Pavan has lost a lot of weight. He has already worked on that thing, but we are talking about any goal that you have in your life. So Pavan, maybe we can start off with some tips. Maybe I would like you to just talk about few things, like maybe three things,
right?
Something like that,
right?
Because I know you can talk about a lot of things,
right?
So maybe we can talk about just three best things,
right?
That three good things that one can follow,
right?
For goal setting.
Absolutely.
So I would now like Pavan to speak.
Sure.
And he should take over from here.
So I think, Ashwini, first thing which comes to goal setting, right? There is a very famous terminology that a lot of my clients use, which is called as BHAG. It is a big, airy, audacious goal. So, you know, actually the problem with goal setting is most of the people want to set goals that are very comfortable. You know, you're not stretching yourself, because they feel that if I set a goal that is realistic and possible, then, you know, I will not disappoint myself of, you know, not achieving it. That is the first thing. Yeah. So when you set a goal, you need to be really, it has to be really audacious, and your hair has to stand up that, wow, how can I achieve that? So your goal has to be really audacious. That is the first thing. The second thing is, before you get to action of how you're going to achieve that goal and all, the second thing you need to do is, what is your why? I mean, your desire has to be very strong for that particular goal. So whenever I speak to companies and whenever I speak to CEOs, vice presidents of companies who have achieved quite a lot, they have this big, hairy, audacious goal, but they have a very strong desire of why they want to achieve that goal. You know, that is the second big thing. I mean, until and unless, and I'm a big fan of Tony Robbins. Even Tony Robbins says that behind every goal, 80% is psychology and 20% is, you know, the plan or the action that you have for your goals. So what most people do is 90% of the effort is on action plan. How many times, I mean, you have developed a great action plan, but you don't do anything about it,
right?
Because there is no internal hunger, there is no internal desire to actually achieve that goal. So instead, 80%, 90% of your time you spend on developing the psychology. I mean, you develop your desire, you develop your psychology, you have strong reasons of why you want to achieve that goal. Once your desire is strong, then you will find reasons. You know, the strategy is not a big part. So you find people who have done it before, then you actually find about, you reach out to people who have done it before, you read books of people who have done it before, you find a way. So when your desire is strong, you try one way, it doesn't work, then you try another way, you try the third way. But then when you focus your attention on 80% or 90% on developing a plan, what if that plan doesn't work? Then, I mean, you're like, 80%, 90% of my time I've spent on developing this plan and it doesn't work. Then you lose the motivation. Most of the people live in the comfort zone. You know, the growth only happens for you when you live beyond your comfort zone.
Right.
So the first thing is, your goal has to stretch you. So I think, Ashwini, the, personal goal, let me talk about the personal goal that I've set for myself. You know, personally, in order to grow, I told myself that every week I will do two things where I'm actually stretching myself outside my comfort zone. So when I say these two things, the thought of doing it scares me. You know, actually, I write down those things, and then when I write it, wow, this is going to be a tough week because I've written down something which I haven't done before, and I'm really nervous about actually getting those two things done. So I started this 1 year back, and I saw myself grow quite a lot because of achieving that. You know, every week was an accomplishment, and one of those goals might be fitness, one of those goals might be actually going and giving a client presentation, approaching a client which I haven't visited before. The public speaking actually gives me a great platform. If I spoke in front of 15 people, the target was speaking in front of 40 people, 50 people. Giving client presentations, if I haven't really stood out in a client presentation and asked the client to really go for bold dreams, that I have done before. That I have done this time, which I haven't done before. So the two things that I committed to myself doing every week when I'm stretching outside the comfort zone, and if I look at myself 1 year back and now, I think I feel a very confident person, and actually I'm aiming for more bolder things. Every day I'm actually getting more bolder and bolder because of this. So this is something which I highly recommend, that do one thing or two things every week where you're stretching outside your comfort zone.
All right, so let's recap all that Pavan has discussed till now. The first thing that Pavan discussed was,
you know, the first step towards achieving your goal is, first is you need to have a big, hairy, audacious goal. The goal actually has to be really big. So for example, if you actually, the goal has to be 10x of what you have done before. It's a big, hairy, audacious goal. That's the first step.
So that means if you have a goal right now, let's talk about money. Maybe you have a goal of earning an X amount of money. Multiply it with 10. Now set a goal of earning 10x. Now it's not only about money, I'm just giving an example. So whatever that you want to do, just multiply 10 to it. When you have a big goal, you will take big steps. Second.
See, the second one is when you have a big, airy, audacious goal, you need a strong desire. So actually, if you look up people, successful people who have built things, they have a strong desire, they have a strong reason.
You see the successful people build right. Big things.
Right.
They had a big desire.
Right. Yeah. So I think I work with a lot of companies, CEOs, vice presidents, and they have a strong desire of why they want to build things, enter new markets, build a great business. I think for your goal, big, hairy, audacious goal, you need to have a strong desire and a big why.
So that means if you have a big why do you want to do it? Maybe if the why is that, okay, my neighbor is doing it, so I'm doing it. I'm doing it because that girl gets impressed. I'm doing it because everybody is doing it. That's not a big why. And if you do something like that, you will never succeed, you will never grow, because you will ultimately get bored, you'll get demotivated. But if you have a big why, then no one can stop you. Now, I love making videos. I've been making videos since 2006, when there was no audience, no money, nothing. I love sharing knowledge, I love making videos. So that's why I've stick all together. And there are a few friends who started making YouTube videos, they quit because they were not getting money, they were not getting motivated, because they did not have that why. Their why was maybe just make videos because everybody is making them. So whatever that you have, if you have attach a big why to it, and that why will take you places. The third part.
I think the third part is, you know, just doing it. You have to take massive action. You know, massive goals need massive actions. So for massive action, I think what one thing I used to suggest was do two things every week where you're stretching outside the comfort zone. So these two things, you know, have to be massive things. They have to really scare you. That's why you're just doing two things every week. So when you do two things every week that are stretching you, you actually stretch yourself. Look at yourself in 1 year from whenever you have started. You actually see that you have become a much bolder, ambitious version of yourself. So it is taking massive action as a third thing.
Wonderful. So thank you very much, Pavan, for explaining all these points to our subscribers. I'm sure you will decide the two massive actions that you will take now. So whatever that your goal is, just write two massive actions that will help you to come closer to your goal. And then work on those two things. Post in the comments if you want to share your goals with us. And when you succeed, share your success stories with us. I wish you all the best. Signing off from Taj Mahal, Ashwani Thakur and Pavan Madamsetty on your channel, Let's Share Solutions.
All the best. Thank you.
And yes, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do, because life's too short. Come aboard.